The basic thing that we have to discuss, what is direct and what is indirect? Direct is what if the same thing, what is happening, is being directed. Suppose if I say, he said, I am going to market. Suppose he said what? I am saying that I want to go to market. If I am telling I want to go to market, this statement is direct statement. Without any medium, you are listening that I am going to market. But if you are listening and somebody had to say that what did sir say? What did sir say? You have to tell me. You have to tell others. Then sir told, that means if you want to write my name, sir told us that he was going to market. The same I am telling that I am going to market, but if you want to say that sir is going to market in reported speech, you will tell that sir told us that he was going to market. So this is the main mantra that we need to pass out the statement closer to farther. Closer to farther. Means nazdik se dur karte hain, to hum log usko kehte hain reported speech. The second is, we have to keep in our mind that present will go in past. Present will go in past. And past as usual transfer into past itself. That means accordingly past indefinite to past perfect does not change. Past perfect continuous does not change. Past perfect continuous and past perfect continuous does not change. Whereas present indefinite into past indefinite into past perfect does not change. Present continuous, past continuous, present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous. Is it clear? Present tense will change into past tense. Another thing that you need to keep in your mind, if reporting verb, means I am just writing here, you should understand, he said, I am going to market. Okay? So this part which is enclosed in double inverted comma, it is called reported speech. This is called reported speech. In short form, I am writing here RS. That means reported speech. And excluded means bahar. Excluded from inverted comma, this part is called reporting verb. In short form, we say RB. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any doubt here?
Sir.
So the first rule says that if this part is in present and another one is also in present, then result will be no change. No change. But it is in past. It is in past. And rest of all is any past or present or future. In any tense, it will be changed. The result would be change. Dhyan rahega?
Yes, sir.
Reporting verb agar past mein hai, और रिपोर्टेड स्पीच पास्ट में हो, प्रेजेंट में हो या फ्यूचर में हो, तो चेंज होगा. जैसा कि अभी मैंने बताया, प्रेजेंट इंडिफिनिट, पास्ट इंडिफिनिट, प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस, पास्ट कंटिन्यूअस, प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट, पास्ट परफेक्ट, प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस, पास्ट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस, एंड एज यूजुअल पास्ट इंडिफिनिट, पास्ट परफेक्ट, नो चेंज. सो यू कैन चेंज इट अकॉर्डिंगली. अनदर थिंग, once again, I am just reminding you, in board examination, at least for the 8 marks, The question from the reported speech is asked. If you want to secure your 8 marks, you should have to work hard for reported speech. Reported speech would be helpful in writing the article, writing the story, and writing the contents even also. Sometimes if you are writing answer by your own, because it is not possible by learning or each and every question answer of your textbook. If you are writing or learning, memorizing one by one all the question answer which is written only in your NCERT textbook, it does not help 100%. That means inside from the text, many questions are asked. If you are going to write by your own way, your grammatical mistake that we say will come in front of you. In order to make it right, you have to practice reported speech, tense, voice. These basic things that we discuss. Right from class 6 onwards, we start learning tense, voice, narration. Many students bother to learn it in class 6, 7, 8, 9, till 9. Some students get mastered in up to class 10 and 12. They are getting late. In CBSE board, you are expected, right from your parent side also, that at least you should have spoken English well and written English both. If you would be able to write and speak, your importance in your family as well as in your society will be increased. Because in coming days, your competition will be very tough. No, 100% everyone will not get government job. They will have to switch themselves towards the private organization. And if you want to serve as a private candidate, and you would be able to earn more than the government officers, government employees, your salary will be hiked. So for that purpose only you should have to be a little bit engrossed, sounded, and sounded by only your educated style, your knowledge. You will be only called, you will be respected everywhere by only your knowledge. So that's why the motto I want to here discuss. So the three rules are there, very genuine rule that I discuss. The first one is the S-O-N. This is called change of person. This is called change of person. I write here change of person. And this change of person is not so tough, because we have to remember nominative case. How many nominative or personal pronouns are there? I, we, you, he, she, it, they. These all are personal pronouns. That we say nominative case also. If I is a nominative form, obviously you will change into possessive adjective. The possessive adjective of I is my, and possessive pronoun is mine. Objective is me, and reflexive is myself. Are you getting what I am saying? So it should be in your mind. No, you are not in class 1, 2, 3 that you need to remember one by one. You should concentrate what I am saying. I, my, mine, myself, me. Same as usual, we, our, ours, ourself, us. You, yours, yours, yourself, you. He, his, himself, him. She, her, hers, herself, her. It. They, their, theirs, themselves, and them. Rest of all, name. Bach gaya kya?
Name.
Name means third person. Third person does not change. If you want to change third person, if it is singular, you should put he or she. If it is plural, it should be kept as a they. Is it easy or not?
Easy.
So this diagram should be made in your mind, that how you are placing out nominative to possessive, possessive to possessive adject, pronoun, and then reflexive and then objective. अगर आई से आई की पूरी ये जो मैंने तुम्हारे दिमाग में बना दिया लाइन, इस लाइन से कोई भी मैच करता है, दैट मीन्स एस ओ एन वी पुट हियर 1 2 3, दैट मीन्स फर्स्ट पर्सन, आई इज द फर्स्ट पर्सन, वी इज द फर्स्ट पर्सन, सो वी इज द प्लूरल ऑफ आई, वी इज द प्लूरल ऑफ आई, सो यू आर प्लसिंग आई इंटू वी और वी इंटू देम, वी इंटू दे, yes, are you getting?
Yes
sir. We into they. Okay. Confusion is, look here, this example, I is the first person, first person according to subject, what is subject? He. So obviously here he, as usual it is present continuous,
past continuous.
It will go in past continuous, you will write here he was going to market.
Yes sir.
Nothing else, it is very easy. In all assertive sentence you should have to place it the same way. Ready?
Yes.
If I am talking about negative, if I am talking about interrogative sentence, remember the interrogative sentence structure? All the model auxiliary. Can you remember?
Yes.
Is, are, am, was, were, has, have, had, do, does, did,
shall, will,
will, would, can, could, may, might, must is model verb, but I am talking about model auxiliary. Model auxiliary that starts a sentence. If a sentence is started by these, is, are, am, was, were, has, have, had, do, does, did, shall, will, would, could, should, can, could, may, might, then we should place out here. I am just giving an example once again here. If I am writing, Am I going to? Obviously, the sentence will be something different.
Yes,
what we are going to do? Now, said will change into asked. Because it is an interrogative sentence. An interrogative sentence, and he will be as usual. Remember, one more thing. Tense of reporting verb. Tense of reporting verb cannot be changed at any cost. You should not think that sir, he said is in past indefinite. Should we convert into past perfect? No. You are only asked to change reported speech in different tenses, not the reporting verb. Reporting verb will not be changed. But the said will be changed as it is. There is an object, you will change it to told if the reported speech is in assertive sentence.
Yes, sir.
Okay? If it is in interrogative, you are changing here asked. But look here, what I told, it is a question mark. If it is a question mark, what should I do? I should place out here if or whether. There are two words, if or whether. Sir, is there any rule? The question rises in your mind, that is there any rule? Whether I should take if or whether, कौन सा ले? If या whether में कौन सा ले? So it depends on you. It depends on you. But there are certain things that could be learnt in higher classes. That whether का use होता है थोड़ा typical. कहाँ पे? If you are emphasizing and giving a condition to the listener, सुनने वाले को एक अगर condition देते हैं, थोड़ा इंफेसाइज करते हैं, उनके ऊपर प्रेशर देते हैं, तो यू शुड यूज वेदर. वेदर का यूज वहां पे करते हैं. अदरवाइज यू शुड यूज जनरली इफ. सो आई एम यूजिंग हर इफ, नो प्रॉब्लम, यू कैन यूज वेदर ऑल्सो. ही आस्क्ड इफ आई इज द फर्स्ट पर्सन सेम एज यूजुअल, ही एंड नाउ वॉज गोइंग टू मार्केट. गॉट इट? गॉट?
यस सर.
If I say, he said to me, can you do this? Once again the question. Now, the said will change into asks. To will be removed.
Yes, sir.
In reporting verb, if there is to can be removed easily. He said to me, if...
I
I means second person according to object as per SO and जिसको समझ में नहीं आएगा वो पूछेंगे, सुनने के लिए कमांड नहीं किया गया. सेकंड पर्सन अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑब्जेक्ट, विच वन इज ऑब्जेक्ट, यू इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट. ओके, तो यू इज अ सब्जेक्ट एंड सेकंड पर्सन इट इज सब्जेक्ट ऑफ रिपोर्टेड स्पीच, सो इट विल चेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू ऑब्जेक्ट. ऑब्जेक्ट इज मी, सो आई शुड राइट हियर आई देन गुड डू एंड दिस विल चेंज इनटू That. अच्छा एक बात तो बताना, किसके किसके दिमाग में आ रहा है सर ये आई कैसे हो गया, तो मी था तो मी लिखना चाहिए था. आया किसी के दिमाग में क्वेश्चन? आया हो तो खुल के बोले, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. आता है ऐसे सेंस में कभी कभी कि सर मी का मी क्यों नहीं लिख दे रहे? अगर आता हो तो इसका आंसर आता है, बोलते नहीं हो बात अलग. एग्जाम होगा तो तुरंत लिख देगा मी, बोले आया था सर क्या करे, उस समय आ गया था. तो मी ऑब्जेक्टिव है, मैंने क्या कहा मी क्या है, और हमको यहां पे क्या लिखना है, सब्जेक्ट लिखना है, यानी सब्जेक्टिव लिखना है. तो इसका ऑब्जेक्टिव अगर मी है तो सब्जेक्टिव क्या होगा, पीछे जा आई, तो दैट्स व्हाई आई रोट हियर एंड कैन वुड कन्वर्ट इनटू कुड. अब सर बोला सर ये तो प्रेजेंट में है, आप बोले थे पास्ट में चला जाएगा, तो कुड डन क्यों नहीं किए? तुम लोग करते हो एग्जाम में, इसलिए ये भी पूछ दिए. क्योंकि वंस द मॉडल चेंज इनटू पास्ट द अदर वर्ब डज नॉट चेंज. क्या बोले? वंस द मॉडल चेंज इनटू पास्ट द अदर वर्ब डज नॉट चेंज, बट इफ देयर इज बी, लेकिन अगर यहीं पे होता कैन यू बी हियर, तो अब गड़बड़ हो गया. अब आई कुड बी देयर, आई कुड बी देयर, बट इफ यू कैन बी रिटन, यू नो कैन बी रिटन, कुड बी रिटन, बी कैन इज आर एम वॉज वर शैल शुड एनीथिंग इफ यू आर राइटिंग, बट जस्ट आफ्टर दैट इफ बी इज कमिंग मेक श्योर द वर्ब मस्ट बी थर्ड फॉर्म, वर्ब मस्ट बी इन थर्ड फॉर्म. But in normal way, if I am writing, sir, what about the future continuous tense? मैं खेल रहा होऊंगा, कल इतने समय में मैं खेल रहा होऊंगा. This is in future continuous. It is continuity, but tomorrow it is expectation. It is your expectation. You are thinking. इट इज पॉसिबिलिटी, ये पॉसिबिलिटी को शो करता, तो उस जगह पे पॉसिबिलिटी की कंटिन्यूटी जब शो करेंगे तो बी4 लगाएंगे. मैं खेल रहा हूंगा, मैं घूम रहा हूंगा, मैं सो रहा हूंगा, तो वो कंटिन्यूटी है मेरी, तो वहां B+B4 होगा. मेरे द्वारा वहां खेला जाएगा, इट इज नॉट कंटिन्यूटी, ऑब्वियसली दैट्स व्हाई इट इज केप्ट इन B3 फॉर्म. अंडरस्टूड? ओके, यहां पर कोई डाउट? The second rule that we want to discuss here, that second one is change of tense. Change of tense. I told you about the change of tense. If reporting verb and reported speech both are in present, no tense will be changed. However, SON formula will work. SON formula will be worked and it will change as accordingly, first person according to subject, second person according to object and third person no change. याद रखेंगे अगर दोनों present में हो या future में हो, present हो या future हो या present future हो या future present हो, so in the same case there should not be any change in reported speech. However, SON will be worked. SON चेंज होगा. लेट मी क्लियर वंस अगेन, इफ रिपोर्टेड स्पीच इज इन प्रेजेंट इंडिफरेंट, इट विल चेंज इनटू पास्ट इंडिफरेंट. कम ऑन टेल मी, ओपन योर माउथ, आई एम आस्किंग, इफ रिपोर्टेड स्पीच इज इन प्रेजेंट इंडिफरेंट, इफ रिपोर्टेड स्पीच इज इन पास्ट इंडिफरेंट. द साउंड इज कमिंग अ लिटिल बिट, शुड आई से समवन टू स्टैंड अप एंड टेल? रिकॉल इट इन योर माइंड, याद कर लो ध्यान से, मैं पूछ क्या रहा हूं, इफ रिपोर्टेड स्पीच इज इन पास्ट परफेक्ट, इफ रिपोर्टेड स्पीच इज इन पास्ट कंटिन्यूअस, विल यू टेल मी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पास्ट कंटिन्यूअस? हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर हियर हु कैन से स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पास्ट कंटिन्यूअस? सी द बैक साइड, टर्न योर फेस एंड सी द रेजिंग हैंड्स. If you don't have any idea the structure of past continuous, that you must be bitten. दूसरा कोई रास्ता नहीं है. पूरा दिन आप लोगों को यहां पे